Buongiorno amici, sono a Seoul e sono in zona Hongdae e mi sto per imbucare in un'azienda di e-sport. Quando sono stato allo startup hub, Katrin mi ha messo in contatto con Brandon, che lavora in un acceleratore di startup. E Brandon mi ha messo in contatto con i ragazzi di questa azienda. Adesso l'appuntamento.
La Corea del Sud non è famosa solamente per il K-pop e per la cosmetica, ma anche perché negli ultimi anni è diventata la patria degli e-sports, cioè videogiochi a livello competitivo. Tutto è partito nel 1972, quando a Stanford, nella Silicon Valley, hanno organizzato il primo torneo di Space War. Poi, 8 anni dopo, Atari ha organizzato il torneo di Space Invaders, che ha portato più di 10.000 spettatori. E poi il resto è storia. I videogiochi più popolari nei tornei sono stati Dota 2, StarCraft, Warcraft, adesso Overwatch, League of Legends e Fortnite. Ma già lo sapete.
Ragazzi, sono entrato e qua dietro di me c'è Emily che mi accompagnerà, mi farà fare un tour.
Okay, so this is Game Coach Academy. We're a professional e-gaming academy here in Seoul, South Korea. We're known for producing and creating training pro gamers that go to teams all over the world. So Game Coach Academy is owned by Big Picture and we also own the team Element Mystic. You can see over here, these are some of the teams that have trained and visited us, but Element Mystic is our own personal team as well. So here, out in the waiting area, sometimes we hold some lectures and presentations for training some of the students. But as you can see over here, we have multiple classrooms where they will train in different games. Currently, our three most popular games are Overwatch, League of Legends, and PUBG. So you can see right now, one of our coaches is giving a kind of lecture. So there's a few different kinds of curriculum that we can have. We have lectures where they're explaining, going over analysts, reviewing new metas and strategies. And then we also have classes as well that are more play style where the coaches are actually observing your play and then critiquing and helping you become a better player.
Who are the coaches? Like pro gamers? How do you become a coach?
Majority of the time, a lot of the players, their career span is very short, usually 16 to 23, 24. So afterwards, what can they do to still work? They become coaches. So a lot of our coaches are actually old, retired pro gamers.
That's great.
Mm-hmm. So not only do we create pro gamers, but we're also creating jobs for pro gamers after their pro gaming career is done. So as you can see, we have multiple students, all different ages, training in all different games. Here at Game Coach Academy, not only do we teach pro gamers, but we also teach hobby classes. So even if you don't plan to be a pro gamer, you can still train here to get better at the games so you can play and beat your friends.
What are they playing here?
Over here, this is PUBG. So PUBG is a really popular game here in Seoul, South Korea.
It's made PUBG? By
PUBG, Battlegrounds.
Ah, Battlegrounds.
In a lot of other countries, there's games like Fortnite, Apex Legends that are really popular, but here we cater to what's really in demand. Our coaches are very flexible. They can teach all different kinds of games, but currently these are the top three games that we're training in. So over here we have one of our Overwatch classes, but also we have private rooms for individual one-on-one classes. Some people will take classes online, so our coaches will teach in here. So this is one facility. We have another academy in another part of the city, but this is our newer and bigger facility.
Game Coach mm-hmm. is just a tiny part of a bigger company, right?
Yes, correct. Game Coach is owned by Big Picture. Big Picture is a multimedia company. We also have a platform and YouTube channel, other media. A lot of the gamers will train here. You have the ability and the opportunity to advance to teams because we own Team Element Mystic as well. These players specifically can train, advance, and go to those teams. But also, our network is incredibly huge with all the teams that we work with, so they have enormous opportunity to be scouted and recruited by other teams as well.
And this is a really new market, right? Mm-hmm. Like 10 years ago, there were no market here, I think. Or maybe there were, because it was StarCraft.
Yeah, well, South Korea in general, this is the hub for esports. A long time ago, StarCraft was really big. This is where all the tournaments are, the players are practicing, but also the gaming culture. So after school, kids go to what's called a PC bang, and there they just play on computers all day. So many kids have been playing that it became so popular. The reason Koreans are the number one gamers in the world is that we have those kinds of resources and that kind of competitive competition as well. The company itself, we started in 2015. There are lots of other companies as well. You think about there's broadcasting companies, there's the companies like the big telecoms that buy these teams and train as well. And and those have been around for a long time.
Because you're producing lots of content, right?
Well, our players will stream. Our main focus, though, is training the players.
And the best players go to Element Mystic?
Not always. Majority of the time, it's like a stepping stone. Like if you would have the minors and the majors in any other sport. I'm from New York, so for example, like basketball, you know, or baseball, you have the minors and the majors. A lot of the time, the students, they'll advance to a collegiate team or our academy team. Then they have the chance to go to one of the pro teams like Element Mystic or in the Contenders League. Then they'll get recruited to the Overwatch League.
Maybe some of them, they can play against Element Mystic in the future.
Yeah, actually, well, that has happened a lot. Some of our players have gone to other teams in the league as well, and they have competed against our team. It's really interesting. We just want our students to be successful no matter where they go.
Okay, ci mettiamo un po' in una stanza. E ci ha raggiunto, what's your name?
Oh, my name is Hyohan Kim.
E lui è uno dei coach. So you teach Overwatch, right?
Yeah, I teach Overwatch.
How did you approach the game?
Since I was a child, I want to be a pro gamer. And Overwatch came out and I was like in the top 500. So some team is asking me to like play in my team. So I joined one of their team. That's the how started my like pro gamer life.
And then how did you become a teacher?
I was 24 years old when I was like starting. That was like a little late, and I discovered I like more when I teach my players, my teammates. So I convert my role as coach. I like to be coach. Yeah.
And what's the most common like problems for students?
They are saying like bad language or
they have a bad attitude.
Because in the game, people doesn't know each other.
So they're aggressive sometimes.
Yeah, they are aggressive and saying bad words.
Mm-mm-mm.
So we are teaching the student to how to like control their mindset and why they should not play in that way.
Mm-hmm. And what's the average age of the student?
Maybe 16 to 18.
Mm-hmm. So they both go to school and come here, right?
This is like an
after school course. Thank you very much. So some question about the industry of gaming. Mm-hmm. You know, I was playing World of Warcraft when I was like 15.
Nice.
It's not a thing anymore here.
Well, it's not as competitive anymore.
I used to play StarCraft also, but I was very bad. Do they play StarCraft even right now?
Yeah, so these days they still have some StarCraft tournaments for StarCraft 1 and 2. They aren't as big as they used to be. They used to have huge filled stadiums full because it was more popular back in the day. I used to go to those events as well.
Is esport comparable to a real sport? Like Olympionic sport, something like that?
Right now, that is the big debate. It's a very new industry, it's a very new sport, but when you think about sports, you think about, okay, a lot of athletes, they get injuries, so do pro gamers. If you pull any of your tendons, you get carpal tunnel, any of these can destroy your career. One of our students had a shoulder injury. He can't play as well. He couldn't get signed to a team. When people think of athletes, they think, okay, they have uniforms, they are sponsored. Our team is sponsored by different brands. A lot of us are sponsored by Red Bull or Monster. We have computer sponsors, like we're sponsored by Logitech, huge stadium. We sell out. You think about the Staples Center over in LA, sold out.
What's the price of a ticket for an event like a tournament?
It really depends, and it depends how much of a spectacle they're making it. So if it's like the world finals, those tickets can get up to, you know, depending on VIP seating, where you are, those can be hundreds of dollars, but it could be sometimes free depending on the event that's being held and who's holding it. These days, a lot of the times like Overwatch contenders can be free to go, but if you go to like Overwatch League, I think it's like $35 a ticket. It really depends where and when.
So there's a rumor we're gonna see esports in the Olympics game. Mm-hmm. Is it true?
Right now, that's the big debate. It was in the Asia Games. A long time ago, they thought skateboarding wasn't going to be in the Olympics or a real sport. It takes time.
How much is big the industry, like the market of esports?
It is a multi-billion dollar industry. A lot of people don't realize it just because it's not as big of a household name yet. But you think about the kids these days, you think about big broadcasting. I mean, in the United States, ESPN is the number one sports channel. They are hosting esports on their channel. Disney, all of these big names are involved. You think about the Overwatch League, they're sponsored by Coca-Cola. The Overwatch League in America is a franchise, just like the NHL, the NFL, the MLB, you have to buy a multi-million dollar slot to get into that league. So one of the biggest questions that I get is, you know, why train at an academy? What is the difference? You know, people, they ask, how do I become a pro gamer? A lot of kids, they just like playing games and they look at it very casually. Oh, they think, I'm good, I can do it. It's very different. One of the biggest reasons Koreans are looked at as the best in the world is how they look at gaming. It's not just, I'm playing. It's not just, oh, it's fun. They take it very seriously, like a job. They study it. They're learning consistently about it. The classes are constantly being updated about the new metas, the new champions, every little detail. So it's not just playing a game anymore. It can be a job.
This is crazy. Even if I'm making a video about that, most of them, they will think,
what is this? If you sign a contract with a major team, you can make a six-figure salary doing that. The top player in Korea makes over $2 million alone in salary. That does not include extra sponsorships and winnings. This is no joke. And a lot of people don't know that. It's still very taboo. People think this is just a game. That was my parents. You know, they're like, you can't make a job with this.
Bene, ha detto un sacco di cose. Tra l'altro mi sono informato e vi lascio in descrizione un articolo tratto da un sito che si occupa solamente di dati riguardanti gli sport. Sport. Vabbè. E in particolare in questo articolo raccontano che quest'anno per la prima volta gli sports hanno superato come mercato il 1.100 miliardi di euro e sta salendo di anno in anno veramente velocemente. Inoltre i fan attivi sono quasi 500 milioni, quindi praticamente più del baseball. So che l'intervista è sembrata un'enorme pubblicità ai videogiochi, ma ovviamente eravamo entrambi di parte. Quindi scrivetemi voi cosa ne pensate nei commenti e mettete mi piace a questo video, mi raccomando, per vedere i prossimi. I mi piace sono importanti. Comunque, per come la vedo io, non è strano che ci sia una scuola di videogiochi. Anche se sono poi pochi i giocatori che diventano milionari, esistono anche le leghe minori e tanti lavori che girano intorno all'industria, come per esempio gli speaker, i cosplayer e gli organizzatori degli eventi. Quindi esattamente come chi vuole diventare un calciatore va a fare lezioni sapendo che verosimilmente non finirà in Serie A, i ragazzi che vanno a imparare i videogiochi probabilmente non si aspettano di diventare il campione dei campioni. Però comunque hanno piacere imparare e magari troveranno un lavoro nell'industria. Comunque, questo era quanto. Spero vi sia piaciuto, ci vediamo con il prossimo video. Condividetelo con i vostri amici videogiocatori. Ciao!